We all know that sweet little someone who will turn the dinner table into a battlefield. And this sends parents into a spiral of frustration, guilt, and inevitable surrender until they give in to their child's demands for Vegemite and white bread, no crust, cut into perfect isosceles triangles for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Meet twin toddlers, Mason and Riley, or as mum jokingly calls them, thing one and thing two. Mason enjoys eating everything mum puts in front of her. Unlike her sibling, Riley cannot have different foods touching on the plate. She won't try anything new and only eats white coloured foods. But none of this matters because tomorrow she will hate everything she liked today. Why do twins who were brought up in the same household together eat so differently? Is it mum contributing to these differences between Mason and Riley through how she feeds each twin? Or is she simply responding to nuances between the twins that have already been written into their genes? Now, fussy eating is the tendency to reject a large proportion of new or familiar foods and is associated with reduced dietary variety and poor food preferences. Previously, it was thought that coercive parental feeding practices exacerbated children's fussy eating. However, recent evidence suggests that fussy eating is likely to be genetically inherited. So we still don't fully understand how parent feeding or child eating works in this circumstance. In my PhD, I wanted to understand parents' role in fussy eating. I collaborated with world-class researchers at University College London, where I worked on Gemini, a large UK birth cohort of 2,402 twins, aiming to assess the genetic and environmental influences on child diet and early growth. Looking at the Gemini twins, I found that if the twins differed in their fussy eating, mum was more likely to pressure and use food bribes with the fussier twin. However, mum's restriction of sugary or fatty foods was similar for both twins, indicating certain food rules in the house despite fussy eating. So, my findings suggest that Mason and Riley's mum was more likely to adapt some of her feeding practices based on each twin's fussy eating. My PhD research will continue to understand how both mums and dads perceive and respond to fussy eating. Findings from this research will set the scene for future early feeding interventions, supporting parents' efficacy in managing food refusal and improving children's dietary quality. Because parents, like Mason and Riley's mum and dad, are not the problem, but a part of the solution in de-stressing dinner times. Thank you.